Well, thank you so much for having me this afternoon. My name's Brian Kemp. Serving in public office was never part of some grand plan. My wife often says that running for governor was certainly not in the marriage vows. But as I built my business over the years, I really became frustrated with government regulations, taxes, fees, and quite honestly just got fed up and decided to do something about it. I ran for the state senate in a district that was centered around Athens, Georgia, against an incumbent and pulled off an upset. And for two terms, I fought for Georgia families, Georgia businesses, and Georgia's future. In the Senate, we repealed ridiculous regulations. We cut job-killing taxes, defended our constitutional rights, and advanced our Georgia values. Years later, I've had the opportunity to serve as Georgia's 27th Secretary of State. I've used my experience in the private sector to modernize the Secretary of State's office while cutting the budget 25% at one point and providing better services and better outcomes through technology upgrades. It has never been easier to file or maintain your current company's registration in the Peach State. In fact, last year we have a record-breaking over 653,646 business entities file annual registrations with the Secretary of State's office. This figure shattered the 2016 record and we're off to a record pace this year. We've had similar success with our online voter registration system, record turnouts, record number of registrations, as well as record minority participation over the years. During my time as Secretary of State, I have been honored to travel to all 159 counties, and I've worked with many to bring lawbreakers to justice. A lot of people don't realize, but we have a team of 38 investigators in our division of the Secretary of State's office that works with the Attorney General's office, lawyers around the state, to prosecute those who are trying to undermine our elections, take advantage of the elderly, or those who are trying to line their pocket. We've partnered with the GBI, the Gwinnett County DA, and the Fulton County DA to catch and prosecute a massage therapist who was videotaping and photographing clients without their permission. We've also stopped Ponzi schemes, charity scams, illegal loans, and securities fraud in all four corners of our state. I certainly have a track record of fighting and winning for hardworking Georgians. When I ran for the Senate, and also when I campaigned to serve as Secretary of State, I told voters what I was going to do, and then I did it. That certainly will hold true as your next governor. I have a conservative four-point plan that will ensure a bright and promising future for all hardworking Georgians throughout our state. It's a plan that puts Georgians first. Number one, our state has been ranked number one for business 5 years in a row, certainly a designation that we can all be proud of. But as your governor, I have another goal in mind, and that is to make Georgia number one state for small business. And after 30 years in the private sector, I know that the only way to make Georgia number one for small business is by making state government more responsive, efficient, and accountable. We must take a chainsaw to government regulations that kill jobs, destroy mandates that penalize progress, stand firm against any healthcare overhaul plans that punishes growth. Secondly, as your governor, I'll fight to implement a spending cap that adjusts with population and inflation. This cap is simple. We cut waste, we agree on our priorities like education and public safety, we then pass a conservative budget that reflects our values, then we have tax reform for all working Georgians. Number three, to realize our full potential, we have to treat all communities, including rural Georgia, the same. Better opportunities in education, economic development, infrastructure, healthcare, no matter where you live, and high-speed internet, no matter your zip code. Finally, we have to put hardworking Georgians first, and as governor, I will do that. Thank you so much for having me today. I'm looking forward to your questions.
Thank you.